आज आपण बघायचं आहे एब्सोल्यूट प्रेशर अँड गेज प्रेशर. इन लास्ट व्हिडिओ वी हॅव स्टडीड ऍटमॉस्फेरिक प्रेशर, अबाउट ऍटमॉस्फेरिक प्रेशर. नाउ टुडे वी विल सी एब्सोल्यूट प्रेशर अँड गेज प्रेशर. फर्स्ट वी सी, कन्सिडर अ टँक फिल्ड विथ वॉटर, फिल्ड विथ वॉटर और लिक्विड. दिस इज अ टँक एंड धीस टँक वी हॅव कन्सिडर एन इमॅजिनरी सिलेंडर. दिस इज अ टँक इमॅजिनरी सिलेंडर X1, X2, Force F1, Mg F2. Now, in this tank, we have filled water, means liquid. This is air, this is water. Now, here, consider an imaginary cylinder. In this cylinder, the height of the cylinder is H, and H is the height of the cylinder. X1 be the level at the top of the cylinder. X2 be the level at the bottom of the cylinder. Right? This is H. See here, in this cylinder, there are three forces, F1, F2 and weight mg. Now in this cylinder contains the liquid, means water. In this cylinder contains water, and the height of this water column is H, and X1 be the level at the top surface of the cylinder, X2 be the level at the bottom surface of the cylinder, and A be the area of the cylinder, base area of the horizontal base, area of the horizontal base of the cylinder, of the cylinder. In last video we have studied atmospheric pressure. We know very well what is atmospheric pressure. Now on this cylinder, the vertical forces acting on the cylinder. There are vertical forces acting on the cylinder are as follows. The vertical forces acts on the cylinder are F1 force acts in downward direction, force act in downward direction, F1 is the force acting in downward direction due to the weight of the liquid column. Second, F2 with the force, if the force acts upward direction due to the water below the surface of the liquid. Below the surface of the liquid. And next, last, third point is that, third, F1, F2, now the gravitational force acts on the water in the cylinder. Acts on the water in the cylinder in downward direction. Is mg. Now see here, this is the cylinder. This cylinder acting three forces, F1 downward direction due to the weight of the liquid, and F2 with the force acting upward direction due to the water below the surface of the liquid. This F2 is this force. Now mg is the gravitational force acts on the water in the cylinder in downward direction. Yes, cylinder madhya liquid var force act vala gravitational force and tyamule weight hi downward direction hai. Manje tumhi figure madhe baghitla ya cylinder madhe tar F1 ani mg downward direction hi ahet, while F2 in upward direction. But we know that what is pressure? Pressure is nothing but force per unit area. So that we know here. So these are the three forces acts as shown in figure on the imaginary cylinder. Now see here, as the water in static equilibrium. In static equilibrium, the balance force in magnitude are now there are three forces acts on the imaginary cylinder as shown in figure, F1, mg and F2. So now this liquid at static equilibrium condition, when this at static equilibrium condition, then F2 equal to F1 plus F2 equal to F1 plus mg, where m is the mass of the water liquid column, mass of the water in the liquid in the cylinder. Now here, but F2 equal to P2 A and F1 equal to P1 A and mass M equal to density into rho. We know that mass into density into volume of the cylinder. Volume of the cylinder. Now density is rho and volume A into X1 minus X2. X1 be the level and X2 be the level measured from the reference point. X1 and X2 be the level measured from the reference point. And that's why here rho A H, X1 minus X2 equal to H. Now, in this case, we see here, F2 equal to P2 A, F1 equal to P1 A, like this. Now, see here, but here, now in this equation, equation number 1 and equation number 2, now, see here, F2 equal to F1 plus Mg, then, here, F2 equal to, substitute this equation, equation, put the value of equation 2 in equation 1. Equation 2 in equation 1. Then we get P2A equal to P1A plus M means rho A X1 minus X2 into G. Now equation number 3. We say equation number 3. Now here A cancel here. A. P2 equal to P1 plus rho X1 minus X2 into G. Right? X1 minus X2 into G. Now this equation can be used as to find the pressure inside the, this equation can be used as to find the pressure inside the liquid of the cylinder. So, equation number 4. Now, here, this equation can be used as to find the pressure inside the liquid of the cylinder. But, here, we studied here. Now, here, the pressure P, to find the P at depth H below the surface of the liquid means now here now here, this is the cylinder. एक्स वन एक्स टू, एक्स वन एक्स टू एंड हियर पी वन पी टू, पी वन पी टू एंड दिस इज एच 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 सी एर. नाउ दिस सिलेंडर जस्ट बिलो द सरफेस ऑफ द लिक्विड, जस्ट बिलो द सरफेस ऑफ द लिक्विड, देयर फोर लेट पी बी द प्रेशर एट डेप्थ एच, एक्स वन बी द लेवल एट द टॉप एंड एक्स टू बी द लेवल एट द बॉटम टॉप ऑफ सिलेंडर, बॉटम ऑफ सिलेंडर राइट एंड पी नॉट एटमॉस्फेरिक प्रेशर, एटमॉस्फेरिक प्रेशर पी नॉट एटमॉस्फेरिक प्रेशर. सो हियर हियर एक्स वन इक्वल टू जीरो, पी टू इक्वल टू पी, एक्स टू इक्वल टू माइनस एच एंड 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 पी वन इक्वल टू पी नॉट. देयरफोर दिस वैल्यू पुट इन दिस इक्वेशन नंबर फोर, पुटिंग दिस वैल्यू इन इक्वेशन नंबर फोर वी गेट, हे वैल्यू इक्वेशन नंबर फोर मध्य पुटअप कराए, इक्वेशन नंबर फोर मध्य पहा मग आता पी टू इक्वल टू पी, पी वन इक्वल टू पी नॉट प्लस प्लस रो एक्स टू म्हणजे मायनस एच म्हणजे एच जी, म्हणजे इथं याला असं लिहू शकतो आपण पी नॉट प्लस एच रो जी, हे मायनस एच हे मायनस एच प्लस होईल आणि म्हणून पी नॉट एच रो जी म्हणजे पी इक्वल टू पी नॉट प्लस एच रो जी इक्वेशन नंबर फाईव. दिस इज द दिस इक्वेशन गिव्ज द टोटल प्रेशर और एब्सोल्यूट प्रेशर, टोटल प्रेशर और एब्सोल्यूट प्रेशर, टोटल प्रेशर और एब्सोल्यूट प्रेशर. दिस इक्वेशन गिव्ज टोटल प्रेशर और एब्सोल्यूट प्रेशर, टोटल प्रेशर और एब्सोल्यूट प्रेशर. इक्वेशन नंबर फाइव गिव्ज टोटल प्रेशर और एब्सोल्यूट प्रेशर, टोटल प्रेशर और एब्सोल्यूट प्रेशर. नाउ वी फाइंड नाउ जनरली द डिफरेंस बिटवीन, द डिफरेंस बिटवीन, द डिफरेंस बिटवीन द एटमॉस्फेरिक प्रेशर, the difference between the absolute pressure, absolute pressure and atmospheric pressure, is called as gauge pressure, is called as gauge pressure, is called as gauge. What is gauge pressure? The difference between the absolute pressure and atmospheric pressure is called as gauge pressure, is called as gauge pressure. Therefore P minus P naught equal to H rho G, P minus P naught equal to H rho G. Why? Here in this equation P naught is the atmospheric pressure and h rho is the pressure due to the height of the liquid column. Height of the liquid column. Now, this is the gauge pressure. But we will find the pressure above the surface of the liquid. To find the pressure above the liquid surface at distance D, as shown in figure. Now this cylinder, now we consider this cylinder this is the cylinder. X1, X2 and D. P1, P2. This is the cylinder. Now this cylinder above the surface of the liquid at distance D. The height of the cylinder is D. So here, now the same, we know that we will get P equal to P naught plus H rho G. But here, rho equal to rho air. Now this cylinder in air. Therefore, rho equal to rho air. And when we have put these values, now here, X1 equal to D, P1 equal to P, and P2 equal to P naught and rho equal to rho air. Rho equal to rho air. Therefore, the above equation can be written as P equal to P naught minus D rho air into G. D rho air minus G. This is the expression for pressure. So in this way we have studied the absolute pressure and gauge pressure. What is gauge pressure? Gauge pressure is nothing but the difference between the absolute pressure and atmospheric pressure is called as gauge pressure. We have studied, that is P minus P naught equal to H rho G. We will get the P minus P naught equal to H rho G. So in this way, we have studied the absolute pressure and gauge pressure. Means we get the main expression is that. What is the main expression? That is the P equal to P naught plus H rho G. P equal to P naught plus H rho G. P equal to P naught plus H rho G. This is the pressure. This is the atmospheric pressure. This is the height of the liquid column. Pressure due to height of liquid column. And this is the total pressure or absolute pressure. Total pressure or absolute pressure. What is P? P is the total pressure or absolute pressure. And difference between the absolute pressure and atmospheric pressure gives the gauge pressure. Simple. So, in this way, we have studied. This is the absolute pressure and gauge pressure. Okay? Thank you.